the auto world, historic model names carry a lot of weight. At Ford, it's Mustang, at Chevrolet, Corvette, and at Cadillac, well, there'll probably always be a DeVille. These names are important because their familiarity gives buyers a sense of each brand's image and personality. But what if you're in charge of Ford's Mercury brand? What image there is old and ill-defined. So to put some youthful spunk in the brand, you could drop its most enduring model names altogether, or try them out on completely different types of cars. Mercury planners chose that latter approach for the all-new 1999 Cougar. But can they really teach an old cat new tricks? One of those tricks being going back to the past to seek inspiration for the present, and one used successfully by other automakers seeking to rejuvenate a flagging lineup. And while you can't exactly call the new 1999 Mercury Cougar a retrospective car, it is, after all, the first front-wheel drive Cougar, the philosophy behind the car's design certainly is. As the designers and engineers at Ford have taken the Cougar back to its 1967 roots, a snappy two-door coupe with a little more substance than the traditional pony car, and plenty of style as well, as the contour mystique-based Cougar is the first car sold in North America showcasing Ford's new edge design theme. A blend of sharp creases and rounded contours, it sets the Cougar apart not only from its contemporaries in the Ford Mercury lineup, but from just about everything else on the road as well. The Cougar's feline features start up front with projector headlamps behind a pair of cat-eye bubble lenses, and a lower air intake that brings to mind the sly grin of a Cheshire cat. The sleek, upswept belt line gives the Cougar a ready-to-pounce stance and merges nicely with the blistered taillights that serve as both a stylish design statement and more practically to meet the various side visibility requirements in overseas markets. Stylish and practical also describe the Cougar's interior. Its more intimate cockpit-like layout is far removed from the Mystique sedan. The cloth-covered front buckets are well-cushioned and offer excellent lateral support. And available side impact airbags help protect both the chest and head. This is a first for Ford in North America and a first in the sporty coupe class. In addition to the usual manual adjustments, the driver's seat gets an adaptable lumbar support and a standard power height control. The minimalist gauge cluster features an oversized tach and speedometer, but it also includes a trip computer, another unexpected standard feature. While just to the right are the smooth rotary climate control switches that send air through the funky-looking vents, and the fine-sounding stereo with a small detachable front panel that disables the unit, making it less appealing to thieves. In the center console, the standard 5-speed cable-operated shifter is one of the smoothest we've encountered on a domestic car. A 4-speed automatic, especially developed for front-wheel drive, is available. Behind the console, rear seat room is sport coupe tight, and the heavily sculpted seat bottoms are a challenge for those wide of hip. Headroom is, however, better than expected. But hey, if it's your car, you won't be riding back here anyway. The 12.4 cubic feet of cargo space beneath the rear hatch, on the other hand, is very usable and gets even better when the 50-50 split seatbacks are folded. This cat can carry a lot of baggage and can move it smartly down the road, too, as purring under the hood of our Cougar was Ford's proven 2.5-liter Duratec V6. Delivering 170 horsepower and 165 pound-feet of torque, the all-alloy Duratec features variable intake geometry, lightweight hollow camshafts, and an advanced EEC-5 electronic engine management system. The standard engine is the equally reliable 2-liter ZTEC 4-cylinder, producing 125 horsepower and 130 pound-feet of torque. Improvements to this engine have focused on structural changes that have reduced engine noise and harshness and improved durability even more. Under V6 power, our Cougar leapt to 60 in 7.9 seconds and on past to the quarter mile in 15.9 seconds at 87 miles per hour. Our drivers liked its strong pull offline, the positive solid feel of the 5-speed, and great sounding exhaust. Even more impressive was its performance through the slalom. The variable rate power assisted rack and pinion steering was quick and precise. The McPherson strut front quadrilink rear suspension it shares with the Contour Mystique line has been tweaked with stiffer springs and stabilizer bars to provide more body control during abrupt transitions. Like heavy braking, for instance, Despite a bit of expected nosedive, the Cougar remains stable and straight in its descent from 60 in an average 116 feet. Thanks to the four-wheel disc and four-channel ABS system borrowed from the Contour SVT. That hardware comes standard with the V6 and is optional on the four-cylinder. These nearly impeccable track manners are also manifested on the highway, as the Cougar delivers up an exceptionally solid and comfortable ride for a small sport coupe. Although it was out on the open road that we noticed a slight reluctance in the steering's ability to center itself, nevertheless, this cat is one enjoyable driver. Even more so when you realize it doesn't cost an arm and a leg to catch this cat. The manually equipped four-cylinder is priced at $16,595, with an automatic bumping the price up to $17,410. Our choice and our tester, the V6 with the 5-speed, rings up at $18,495, with the automatic bringing the price to $19,310. But it's the solid feel and superb road manners that tops our list of hits, followed by the Cougar's affordable price and eye-catching exterior and interior styling. Misses are few. In fact, we found only one, the confining rear seat bottoms, which will eliminate a lot of backseat passengers. And on second thought, that might not be such a bad thing. Because after all, the feline breed has always been an independent beast, and the new 1999 Mercury Cougar is a car for independent-minded people. And despite its rather erratic lineage and a past tendency to put on weight, make no mistake, this kitty ain't no lap cat.
This is the Ford Puma, Top Gear's car of the year. It's cheap to run, lovely to look at, and absolutely great to drive. So you can imagine our delight when we heard that it was to get a bigger brother. And here it is, the Cougar. Let's deal with the facts first. It was designed in Europe, but it's built in America. It's available with a 2-litre engine or a 2.5-litre V6. However, if it wants to be number one, it has to beat this. This, of course, is the brand new 3-litre Alfa Romeo GT V6. It's my favourite coupe of them all. It is pricey, I'll admit, but it looks fantastic. And it goes like stink, and that badge is a bit more of a bird puller, I think, than the blue oval.
On this week's programme, well, we've also got a Ford Cougar. And here's Richard Hammond with a lowdown on the Cougar.
Oh, dear. Remember when you were a kid and you used to build an oil rig out of cereal packets and loo roll tubes? Well, mine looked exactly like this, only it was built slightly better and probably looks slightly better even now. But you were worried about your speaker space. Look at this boot in a coupe. You'd get stadium kit in there. But hold on, if we're going to start judging a coupe according to boot space and rear seat accommodation, there's something wrong buying a state car. And here's a worrying point. It's got a tow ball on a coupe. Isn't that a bit like buying a scooter with bull bars or trying to fit a roof rack to a soft top? The thing about the Cougar to me is, looking at it, do you not get the impression that somebody somewhere in Ford was trying just a little bit too hard to please their boss when they designed it? I mean, look, yeah, nice one, Dave. Now make me one that looks pretty. This ridiculous idiot grin. Does anybody really want a sports car that when you open the garage door is there? I go fast, me. Nasty. And it seems like the world would agree because last year Ford sold one. And if that was you, it's so bad they've killed it off completely. And frankly, I agree with them. I'm sorry, Cougar, you were never any good. Good riddance.
Still, the Ford is not a bad looker thanks to some sublime detailing. Whoever designed this car put some real effort into it. There's the space in the back. There's actually more in the Cougar than you get in most coupes, which is nice, but not terribly important. I don't even care that it's got a pretty colossal boot. You see, if I want something useful, I'll buy a washing up bowl. I don't care either that underneath this angular new edge body, you find the Cougar is basically a tartan up Mondeo. I don't care because there's nothing wrong with the Mondeo. The top of the range ST24 is one of the most underrated saloons that money can buy. It's huge fun to drive. And as a result, so is this. As this has the ST24's engine, you've got a nice choice, really. The Mondeo if you want four seats, or this if you want to look good. Mind you, they have made some mild mechanical changes to make this feel a bit more sporty. The pedals are perfectly positioned for heel and toe gear changes, and the driving position, well, I just can't think of any car that gets it better. At the right time and in the right place, this thing absolutely flies. The grip is just amazing, and the feedback coming through the steering wheel is brilliant. The V6 engine's an absolute barnstormer as well. There's a sort of muted roar when you get to the top of the rev range. Cougar. They should have called it the Ford Big Angry Lion. The trouble is, it isn't actually all that fast. With just 168 brake horsepower, the top speed is only 137, and 0 to 60 takes a ponderous 8 seconds. Meet a GTV6 at the lights and he'll gobble you up without even noticing. So, let's have a think then. The Alpha is faster and better looking, but the Ford is considerably cheaper and more practical. It's anybody's game.
And it doesn't help when you come inside either. The Cougar's dash may feature 6 different types of plastic and therefore be messier than a monkey's breakfast. But it has the sort of toys that Alpha Man can only dream about. Traction control, air conditioning, trip computer, CD. It's got the lot. You get big, comfy seats too, but I wish they had more side support. And I wish there was a clutch footrest too, because this isn't a cruiser. It's an out-and-out sports car.
It is a worthy big brother to the Puma. It's much better than the old Probe. It's a dream to drive, and yet it comes with real-world fuel and insurance bills. Great. But is it better than the Alpha?
I have to make a decision here on two counts. Which car do I most want to drive home tonight? Well, that's the Alpha. And which one do I most want to own for a year? Well, if you've got any common sense at all, you'll take the Ford. But if you've got any common sense, you won't buy a cramped, expensive coupe, you'll buy a nice saloon. But I don't want a nice saloon. I want the Alpha. Ford gets close, but not close enough.
With the kind of development funds at Ford's disposal, you'd expect the drive of the Cougar to be well sorted. And it is. The ride is superb, a great compromise between sporty and comfortable. It is perhaps let down only by rather dull and neutral feeling steering. And the engine, the V6, although there's plenty of mid-range, it does get rather gutless. And there's no particular V6 howl to it, which is a shame. In fact, the only noise you do have tends to be a huge amount of wind noise around
these. As is the Cougar, it really is great fun behind the wheel. The looks, well, I guess you're going to love them or you're going to hate them. A bit like you, Richard, really.
Charming.
Running, head out on the highway, look direction in whatever comes our way. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving place. Fire all of the guns and bombs and explode into space.
Bam. In the movies, the roads of America have come to represent the freedom of the individual spirit, a place to escape and follow your dreams. Perhaps the most famous road movie of all, Easy Rider, has been recreated featuring one of the original stars, Dennis Hopper. Except this time, Hopper has exchanged his Harley for the new Ford Cougar.
It's a kind of retro style commercial really. The idea being that Dennis Hopper of today meets his alter ego and his other self from the movie Easy Rider in Death Valley 30 years later. Yeah, driving the new Cougar, and it's a face-off between the two of them.
The new ad follows hot on the heels of the memorable Ford Puma campaign.
When we develop advertising for Ford, we always try and focus on three key areas of the product. In this case, for the Cougar, we had a provocative styling, obviously. The exhilarating drive is very important, but probably the most important part of the DNA was what we called Wild at Heart.
Research showed that on the outside, potential Cougar drivers may appear conventional, but hidden on the inside is a younger, wilder spirit, a quality that they can express through the car they drive.
The proposition that we came up with for the agency to develop the communication strategy was a single line that basically was a drive that indulges your wild side.
The reason why we chose Dennis Hopper actually weren't simply that of a celebrity endorsement. We used Hopper for two reasons, really. The first, obviously, is that the guy is, by anybody's definition, wild at heart. Secondly, the reason why we used Hopper was the film Easy Rider, which this commercial is wholly based on. And that movie really was a standard at the time, in the late 60s, for that wild at heart spirit of adventure, which we know that all the target audience would really buy into.
It's a kind of duel, they're playing off on each other. So Dennis Hopper still in the car, the older Dennis Hopper, more mature Dennis Hopper, has slightly more cooler edge. And the one on the bike is a bit more erratic and obviously in the same vein as the film.
Because of the technical difficulty of the whole project, a dummy commercial was put together before the shoot took place. The new footage was added to this until the ad was finally complete.
What we did was we cut the film together using, obviously, the riding shots of Dennis Hopper 69 from the movie, and carefully chose the riding shots for the angles. We had to choose the angles first and the size of the bike, because what essentially is going to happen is you have to look at the bike and think, well, the car's got to be next to that bike. So the sizes had to be right and everything has to be right. So from there, not only do you have to choose the sizes, you have to choose, well, what's the action going to be at that point? Is he looking at the car, or is he looking at Dennis Hopper, or is he coming up, or is he overtaking? So all the logistics and geography of the car and the actions have to tie up. And that was a really hard bit, so we spent a long time in England getting it right.
The crew used a mobile computer effects system to check the synchronization of old and new footage, editing the ad together as it was being shot. Only this process allowed the team to develop perfect choreography.
we were the first people globally to incorporate a flame system, which is pretty much what we have here, which is a computer-aided composite special effects system. And we had that on site with us, where we could actually shoot and composite on location and really see if we were getting it right.
The iconic presence of Dennis Hopper in the commercial is the special ingredient that gels the project together.
The fact that Hopper's in it has a certain element of coolness about it. You know, his career is saturated in cool movies and you know, that icon status. The other major bonus, of course, is that the car, the actual Cougar, looks very good. It's a very good looking car.
I mean, some of those looks from Hopper, you know, I mean, that's just magic. And that's what makes the commercial. Look at that cafe scene, the quality cafe. If you or me had sat in there, nobody would have batted an eyelid. But once Dennis sat in and looked, magic.
You've got the car, you've got you've got Dennis, you've got the music, you've got the location. I'm looking for adventure. Okay. And whatever comes our way. Yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving grace. Fire all of your guns at once and explode into space. Select the true nature's child. We were born.
It is this magic combination that evokes a sense of freedom and adventure, a perfect setting for the new Ford Cougar.